How exactly has this false teaching of eternal torment worked? People say, well, you need this to scare people straight. People laugh at this.
Yeah.
You see cartoons on it in the newspaper because no person who can still think is going to believe that God is actually going to burn somebody for eternity forever.
I couldn't agree more with you, Martin.
A few sins. I mean, we're poor, weak vessels. Some people are born to mothers who are on crack, and people are just, we have so many weaknesses that beset us. And the fact, the idea that a loving God would torment someone for eternity for not being able to pull himself up by his bootstraps in this life, people laugh at it. It's ludicrous. Mm-hmm. It does not keep anyone from sinning, and I will go as far as to say it causes people to sin. The world is rebelling against God, not because God is hideous, but because Christianity has painted him as a hideous God.
By the way, Martin, you just hit on something so important,
mm-hmm.
because in Genesis 3, when Satan came to Adam and Eve there, to Eve,
mm-hmm.
they judged God by Satan's words.
Good point, yes.
Satan said, God is withholding good from you.
Yeah, that's right.
And why did they hide from the Lord God? Mm-hmm. Because they had listened to Satan's estimate of God.
That's right.
Yes.
It was right. What was the sin in the universe was questioning God's word. God said, of every tree of the garden, you may eat it. Eat it, all of it, freely. God gave them great things, and Satan accused God of withholding the best out of jealousy.
Yes.
And so mankind's problem is they have a satanic, now this is a hard statement, we have a satanic view of God. People judge God based off of Satan's lie. What was Satan's lie? You shall not surely die.
You won't die.
And so because man doesn't like death, they think, well, death can't be the end. So they invent that they say things like death is life in another place because we want to magnify man to this immortal creature. And so we have instituted a religion today that is using Satan's view of God as orthodox teaching.
Well, not only that, Dan, but 1 Timothy 4:1 says, now, I'm quoting from Scripture here, 1 Timothy 4:1, the Spirit is saying explicitly, this is prophecy, that in subsequent eras, some will be withdrawing from the faith, giving heed to deceiving spirits and the teachings of demons in the hypocrisy of false expressions.
Mm-hmm.
In the last couple shows, we've told you that the phrase eternal torment is a false expression based on faulty translations of the scriptures. And I want to ask you this too. Deceiving spirits and the teachings of demons. What would a demon teach except the failure of the cross of Christ? Do you think Satan likes the teaching of the salvation of all? No.
Yeah.
And he's fighting hard to keep millions of people ignorant of it. And in fact, he's the one who invented the false teaching of eternal torment. This is a teaching of demons. And if you're a demon and you want to teach, you're going to teach that the demons win. And indeed, the doctrine of Christianity says that Satan is going to win most of mankind from Christ for eternity. That's a deciving spirit.
Right.
Inciting that.
You know, Martin, I think you bring up a good point because I think that, on the contrary, the doctrine of hell doesn't save people. You might be able to scare somebody for a time with it, but I think what it does is it hurts the cause of the gospel.
Oh, my God.
Because you're
now,
not
if
showing...
you come, here's the other thing. If you're scared into believing God,
mm-hmm.
if you're scared into believing on him because of a fire, you're not believing in God because the evangel, the gospel that brings salvation, is not the message of torment. It's the message
right.
of the cross.
Right.
Yes.
And people, somebody once said to me, well, it was hell that got me to believe.
Mm-hmm.
No, it wasn't. If you believed in hell and you were just afraid of going to a place called hell, you're not believing in God.
That's not true.
That's not the
that
gospel.
Is not saving
yeah.
faith.
No, because it's not saving faith because you're not all you're doing is, you think that God's going to torture you. And by the way, that's why people offer sacrifices to pagan gods. I just saw the movie Apocalyptical, Apocalyptical, Apocalypto recently. Why did they offer those human sacrifices to their gods.
To appease
the gods.
Says, hold off the anger.
And the new sacrifice says, well, we need to believe God, because if not, he's going to torture us.
It's really attributing our living God, idolatrous, what's the term I'm looking for? Features or attributes, idolatrous attributes of a false God. That's really what it's doing.
That's what, Martin, you read in 1 Timothy 4. It says here,